In this video, we are going to talk about 10 most dangerous borders, so before starting this video, please like this video, and subscribe to our channel for the future updates. The real world has hundreds of national borders, many of which are contentious and some of which are lethal, far from the utopian discourse of a borderless earth. The world's most dangerous borders all have one thing in common: you don't want to be caught there. While the underlying reasons for each dispute differ, some of them may be waiting for a spark while others may be frozen in time. Here's a list of the 10 most dangerous borders. Let's start. Number 10. Pakistan/Afghanistan. The Durand Line, which runs 1,510 kilometers between Pakistan and Afghanistan, is the border. The border has been a point of contention for many years, most recently by the Taliban and then the Afghan president in 2001. Both sides' military forces engaged in armed warfare there in 2003, and Pakistan started building fence lines to prevent Taliban insurgents from crossing 4 years later. The lack of government supervision, the fact that everyone is armed, and the fact that this location frequently experiences murder, kidnappings, and illegal smuggling all make it dangerous. Number 9. Sudan and Southern Sudan. Omar Hassan al-Bashir, the president of Sudan, previously declared that he would not accept Southern Sudan's independence if its government attempted to claim the Abyei region, which is a part of Southern Kordofan. Accusing Southern Sudanese militias of ambushing its forces on June 5, Khartoum began a military offensive in Southern Kordofan. According to UN estimates, Khartoum's takeover and bombing of the disputed Abyei region resulted in the displacement of more than 113,000 people. Number 8. USA and Mexico. Despite being the busiest border in the world, it is not necessarily safe to cross. Things quickly turn ugly between border posts. Each year, hundreds of thousands of Mexicans make illegal entry attempts. Lethal force is occasionally used by the U.S. Border Patrol, although it does happen. The overzealous civilian vigilante border patrols are another issue. However, the main cause for worry is drug trafficking and the violence it has generated. While several Texan border towns are among the most violent in the nation, the cities of Juarez and Reynosa on the Mexican side have started to resemble war zones. Number 7. China/North Korea. The Pekto Mountains, the Tumon and Yalu Rivers, and North Korea's border with China are what divide them. This border has lax protection and is frequently used by North Korean refugees. Both nations started building walls and fences over the past 10 years. Territorial issues have raised concerns since the start of Kim Jong-il's reign and with a rise in North Korean immigrants in China. As low-level officers receive meager food rations, there have also been tales of North Korean soldiers crossing the border to steal food and cash. China sent about 2,000 troops to the border in April 2016 in response to rumors that Pyongyang was preparing a nuclear test. Number 6. Cambodia and Thailand. The Priya Bihir Temple, which is close to the border, has been a source of conflict between Cambodia and Thailand for years. Thailand claims that the region was never entirely delineated and attributes the ambiguity of the map to the French colonization of Cambodia at the turn of the 20th century. The 11th century Hindu temple was given to Cambodia by the International Court of Justice in 1962 after a protracted legal battle. However, the disagreement over the 1.8 square mile region surrounding the sacred place has never been settled. Number 5. Israel and Palestine. These two states are divided by a line of change and strife that seems never-ending. Gaza plus a portion of the West Bank make up all of Palestine at the moment. Israel actually shut down Kerem Shalom and Erez, the only two points of entry and exit into Gaza, in 2017 over security concerns. Since then, both have been opened and closed numerous times. Israel also cut off the whole West Bank and Gaza over the 11 days of Jewish holidays that same year. There isn't a guaranteed safe route to cross these borders due to the almost daily fighting between Israel and Palestine. Number 4. Israel/Syria. Israel and Syria have been at odds over their shared border for a long time. The Syrian side was given to France when Britain redrawn the borders in the early 1920s. Later, when the Golan Heights were added. This territory has been hotly fought for almost a century. The two nations have fought one other multiple times, each time seizing control of different territories. Right now, the border is a hotbed of combat, with shots coming from both sides. Number 3. India and Bangladesh. History and geography bind India and Bangladesh together. With the help of India, Bangladesh, previously East Pakistan, conquered West Pakistan in a violent civil war in 1971 that claimed more than a million lives and destroyed the nation's infrastructure and economy. Since then, the fledgling nation has had difficulty bouncing back. The India-Bangladesh border was one of the bloodiest international frontiers in the past 10 years, despite the fact that it was rarely in the news. Number 2. South Korea/North Korea. The 160-mile border separating North and South Korea is known as the Korean Demilitarized Zone, DMZ. This region has barbed wire fencing, live landmines, and is strongly guarded by troops from both sides. Since the two countries have been at war for more than 60 years and do not recognize each other as sovereign states, the end of the Korean War achieved nothing to put an end to hostilities between them. Under these difficult conditions, hundreds of people have passed away, including Americans. Number 1. Venezuela and Colombia. The state of affairs today is completely different from a year ago. President of Colombia Juan Manuel Santos, who took office in August 2010, reconciled with Chavez as one of his first actions. This strengthening of links has brought about significant changes on the ground for left-wing guerrillas, who have been increasingly faced by Venezuela after spending years hiding on the Venezuelan side and out of the reach of Colombian security forces. Due to the 200 guerrilla militants that returned across the border into Colombia as a result, there has been an increase in violence in Colombia's Arauca border region. In addition to nearly 200 uniforms, the vehicle was reportedly transporting 1.5 tons of explosives, 16,000 feet of detonation rope, 17 guns, 42,000 rounds, and approximately 500 FARC combatants in Arauca. What do you think of our video? Let me know in the comments section below. If you enjoy this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit that subscribe button before you go. Thanks for watching.